Andy Roman here. I'm here today to talk about what I call lazy brain syndrome, which really is a physiological wiring for our brain to do as little as possible. You could call it efficiency, to do as little as possible to keep us oriented and that sort of a thing. And unfortunately, that results our own tendency to be stingy with reality leads us to be bored, to take things for granted, to be restless, and ultimately to really, it's at the root of depression. And you know, it's not our circumstances that trigger this. It's our own tendency of how we process the world. You know, things were brand new when we were brand new. And I believe that the goal of enlightenment, the goal of being real, is to experience the world brand new. A famous person once said, live this life, experience this miracle of life as if it has never happened before. And I know I've seen that kind of quality in little children. I used to be a nursery school teacher, and I would see that all the time. It was refreshing, you know, just the preconceptual in-touchness that children have. What kind of effort can we make to get more in touch with reality as is? And you know, I think many addictive substances, we use addictive things to alter our consciousness because we want to get out of the ruts of that our brain has created for us. And so we will do extreme things to get out of it. That's how compelling it is. Even Carl Jung said that alcoholism, for instance, as an addiction, was a misguided spiritual quest. It wasn't because of bad or low life character. It was a misguided attempt to be in touch, to alter our reality, to get high, to be brand new, which in my opinion is a noble endeavor. We just mess it up. We misguide it. And so his thing was, he came up with a little saying, spiritus contra spiritum, which means the spirit to combat spirits, if you know what I mean. And so how do we get brand new? I think this happens at a feeling level. When we're touched, you know, even tragedy, especially tragedy, really takes us out of the timeline, the rut line of our life, and awakens us to the fragility and the temporary nature of our life. But how do we get to the point where we focus on our existence and not our circumstances? That's the challenge. That's the thing. And I like to think that my book, you knew this was coming, didn't you? My book, Get Real, Get Well, The Power of Authenticity to Heal, addresses this through stories that really show transformation, where people shift from seeing things in one way to seeing things completely new, in a way that relieves them. Inevitably, that involves tapping into the feeling level, because that's where things get stuck and that's where things get liberated. So we need each other to help each other. Let my book help you. Why not? Let my book help you. I think you will enjoy the stories. I think you'll be inspired by it. It's good information, good content. And it's a really practical thing that applies to everyone. It's not our circumstances. It's not changing circumstances that really alters our mindset. It is inner work that alters our perceptions. You know, change your mind, change your world. Okay, thank you for your attention. Thank you for listening. Thank you for being interested. And carry on. Let's have a good life. Peace out.